Testing 1, 2, 3. Loud and clear tonight, I hope.
Purpose. And I figure the simplest way to do this is just to sort of unload on you how I see these things. Shamanism is not some obscure concern of cultural anthropologists. Shamanism is how religion was practiced for its first million years. Up until about 12,000 years ago, there was no other form of religion on this planet. That was how people attained some kind of access to the sacred. And so shamanism then becomes about technique. And if any of you are students of the literature of shamanism, you probably know that one of the great overviews of shamanism is contained in Mircea Eliade's book, Shamanism, the Archaic Technique of Ecstasy. The Archaic Techniques of Ecstasy. In other words, shamanism is not so much a religion as ordinarily conceived, as it is a kind of pre-rational science, a kind of methodology for attaining a certain kind of experience. And then the question becomes, what experience and what's so great about it? Well, the experience that is attained, if we can attempt to rise to some kind of cosmic overview so that we are not dealing with the experience in the context of what the Maza texts say, or the Witoto, or some other tribal people. But when we attempt to pool all of this descriptive data, then what is the experience that the shaman is having that is making him or her an exemplar in their own society, and in a sense, almost superhuman? Well, if you analyze thousands and thousands of these shamanic experiences, both drug, both plant-induced and non-plant-induced, the overwhelming connecting thread is boundary dissolution. This is what the experience is that we are all seeking, that we call terrifying, wonderful, desirable, horrible. But what it is it's the experience of having the roof fall in and the floor fall out, all at once. Boundary dissolution. Why should that be so important, so wonderful? Because it acts psychologically.
And just like that, from Seattle to Chicago, Psy Life Raid Train rolls on. Thanks for the raid, Tris. I really enjoyed your stream tonight. Took me a little while to get set up down here. I got two kids running around, but I really did enjoy it. And I hope everybody's having a great Psy Life weekend. If this is your first time here, I want to welcome you to Studio 5 in Chicago, where the weather's very hot and muggy, but nice and cool down here for the time being. But I'm hoping to heat it up with some hot tracks here. Let's go. Tris, thanks again. I heard what you were saying about the summers in Seattle. Trust me, I miss those beautiful summers out there. I was only there for 16 years. It's not a fun place to leave, trust me.
The drug has been around for several years, but what we've seen in the last couple of years is an escalation of the availability. It's called ecstasy. Now, who doesn't want to take ecstasy?
Yeah, I was a cave dweller while I was out there. I enjoyed the rain after about, took me about 5 years to get used to the rain, but then I started.
doesn't want to take ecstasy.
I like that name. Probably do know, but Rain is right there in Mukilteo. That's their headquarters. Can you believe it? Of course, they got bought out recently, or fairly recently, by In Music or one of these monster companies. Until then, they were just a small shop in Mukilteo, Washington. I see cheese. Welcome, cheese. Thanks for being here. Lad the DH, welcome. Thanks for the follow.
The Sangha is an embodiment of Buddha's experience and wisdom. What happened?
The first Sangha was a radical institution.
The first Sangha was a radical institution.
Spoken to people from the past.
Drive West. We're going to take you there right after this stream. I was setting up the whole time Tris was playing, basically. Tris, I like the new setup. Did you do that out of necessity, or was that just something you decided to change it up? It's amazing how bugs come out of the woodwork when you're switching things up. It's amazing you got through a stream with no issues. Glad to see that. The moment, or are you out east? this. I moved in here about 2 years ago and feeling a lot of gratitude as well. Cicadas treat you out there. They're coming out in full force around here. A couple weeks back in my, or maybe a week or two back in my yard, and I was digging down about 2 or 3 inches, and they were just, the embryos or whatever you call them, were just thick down. Showing up. Welcome, Cyber. Yahtzee, one of my favorite games, because it's so simple. sleeping upstairs. I can't have the PA system on. I'm mixing all in my headphones. I wish these things could go louder. Dang. Follow my brother Cybertur there if you like house music. Veteran DJ there, y'all. Got neighbors you gotta worry about now. Summer might be my least favorite time. We'll be right back. around 145. Take it up from there. Upshift 64. Welcome. Making me homesick. Let's see what the weather's like out there, Tris. Wow, 53. Perfect. Tonight, thank you, sir. Hope you're doing well out there in Pittsburgh. Got a window in the back corner there. It looked pretty gray. Kind of jealous. Still 81 here, and 1989. Amazing. Southside Jim. Love you, brother. Right over there, but they're off. Painful. Exterior wall here. My kids' rooms are two levels up. It should be feasible. But maybe not with this music. Bass will shake the whole house. Soundproof to where you can crank it. Heck, I don't even see you wearing headphones most of the time, so you must have the volume up high enough to mix on. How about you then, tonight? Crank it when you mix. Man, it's interesting. I think a lot of people have a strong preference one way or the other. I've always headphone mixed. There for the longest time, I always looked for mixers with a split cue button, but I rarely use that anymore. But the cue mix lever on this mixer I had to replace already once.
I feel electric. Electric. Electric.
electrifying. Drift on this DVS, so I kind of have to be a little more careful, I guess, than I am on a controller. And I assume your beat grids are all spot on. Mine, I don't think are. I have to tweak them quite a bit. There, Tris, what kind of gear are you mixing on there? I couldn't quite see it on my phone. I also forget what you're using, DJ, tonight. Great evening. Catch you again soon. Yeah, I've been using only Serato for the last, I don't know, forever. Before that, I was using Final Scratch, if you remember that. I think Traktor and Final Scratch joined back in the day. If I remember, then I think they just abandoned Final Scratch. Bad Acid Psy, welcome, brother. Beer Bomb, welcome. Great to see you guys.
Heart rate is elevated.
Now we got a crew in here, y'all. Next week, Psy-Rate 3. Got a heck of a lineup, man. I think we got 18 or 20 DJs slated for that event.
All of us are human. It could be any of us.
Zach, I noticed that. I've been checking out his streams. Fun, fun, fun stream to watch. Very nice guy, that guy right there. Let's go, Beer Bomb. Bong would be impressed, Zach, but he prefers to bong his beers. Suppose unless he wants to class it up and use a glass on special occasions. That a few times in my days. Although I haven't said that for about 9 years, believe it or not. Haven't had a sip for a while. Long story, but that's what it is. We'll be right back. brother. Pro tip from DJ Zach Tyler, y'all. I trust the guy myself. Grease was always my cure, man. I'm right there with you on that one. I'd be crawling into a Burger King dying for some greasy breakfast. Or if I was lucky, hit a Denny's at 3:45 a.m. Yeah, that's not always an option, unfortunately, there, Southside. Gotta take what you can get. Greasy BK breakfast, about the best I could do. Let me grab something for you there, Jim. Let me show you something. Ivy, oi, welcome. Left from my childhood, here's one. I mean, my Thundercat collection. These are the three relics that survive. New series on Netflix, I think. Beer Bong, great to have you here. Appreciate it. Rest of your day, night. Looking forward to catching you again soon. Worst case scenario, we'll see you next weekend.
spice is the sacred hallucinogen. For the Imperium, spice is used by the navigators of the Spacing Guild to find safe paths between the stars. Without spice, interstellar travel is impossible, making it by far the most valuable substance in the universe.
On most of these tracks throw it off almost every time.
Voice from the outer world.
We'll be right back.
California, San Francisco. Looked like you guys were doing a lot of gigging out there. Were you guys kind of set up shop at one spot there, and were you doing multiple days or an all-day thing? I saw Michael Liu there as well. It's a miracle, my friend. Miracle. I was troubleshooting my track titles down there. Weren't working out. Took me about... It's always something. Every time you fire up, I think. Cyber, are you gonna get any more streaming in this weekend, brother? That was a fun house train last night. I ended up doing an hour and a half. DJ On Direct came in back in after me for round two. Did you jump back on as well? I passed out shortly after On Direct started. Having the kids on my own all week, I was tired. Nice, Zach. On last night, or you didn't pass out, or help me out. You didn't jump back on. Did On Direct just carry on then? I was assuming you guys were gonna do a back to back. You ever heard of a town in Illinois called Jacksonville, DJ Zach Tyler? Hey. Jacksonville's in central Illinois. It's about half an hour from Springfield. That's where I'm from. Northwest with no jobs or anything. 16 years later, I'm finally back home, as you say.
Possibility for the entheogens is that they give us a sense of higher consciousness.
Thank you.
to hear it, man. Precious and amazing is probably something to do with that bad luck. It's all for a reason, man. The good comes with the bad, or whatever that saying is. You know what I mean. Take the good with the bad, whatever they say, you know. Train you're organizing, or that you have been organizing, Zach, Infected, I think it's called. Is that for producers or DJs and producers, or how do you decide who to get in on that? For Green Tree affiliated folks. Thank you. home base out in San Fran then. There she is, Sayakita, welcome back. I enjoyed your stream earlier. I was listening and right in the midst of your technical difficulty there, did you ever figure out what was going on? It sounded like Record Box just like quit responding. Did you have to restart the computer? Because I turned it off for a second, came back, and everything was normal again. Seems like a super nice guy too, man. Speaking of humble, humility, generosity, it pays off, man. Yes, thank you. This weekend, tonight. Gotta get you in on the next Throwback Thursday train tonight. Love to have you on it. Thinking about doing those monthly or bi-monthly. I'm still trying to decide. I got things piling up on you. Is that on Monday? have the flyer handy, unfortunately, but we're very, very deep into Psy Life weekend here, Psy Life 29. I think there's just Zach Tyler and one other Zach, is that right? That's a good problem to have, man. Assuming you can fill, you got enough in your fridge to fill it a few more times, that is. Voodoo Juice track plant wouldn't be a bad beer name. Follow. I know I follow Trinicles. Up and running, Zach. T-minus 15 minutes.
Thank you.
that yard mode, Mize in the mix. The grass is growing like crazy around here. I basically have to go over mine about twice. Psytrance and cornflakes for Pro Silas. Where are you listening from, Pro Silas? Appreciate you being here. Make sure you don't go anywhere. 10 minutes, we're going straight to DJ Zach Tyler. Make that about 5 minutes. For me, y'all, I thank you all so much for tuning in, and I'm flattered to be part of this global Psytrance family. Psy Life is a staple in the Psy Twitch community. But if you didn't get enough this weekend, make sure you keep an eye out for us next weekend. We're going to be on another significant raid train known as Psy Raid 3. A lot of great artists and DJs on that one. So hope to see you then. Peace, y'all. Love you.